bit, and music volume, effects volume, all that good stuff. And I have a feeling that I should just up. Alright. Auto aim, control rumble, show player names. I don't know about that, but we'll just give it a shot. Greetings and welcome. This game instantly supports controller, USB controller, so let's give that a shot. Local game? Oh, come on. Does it really have to have multiplayer? Well, actually, yes. But I would prefer local co-op as opposed to online, but no one has local for computers, so whatever. Start game. Loading. Campaign. Endless. Colosseum. Well, campaign, of course. Can I play, Daddy? Don't hurt me. Bring it on. I just go normal. Constructing the gauntlet. I used to be a fan of gauntlet. I was a fan of the Valkyrie, who always had the highest defense. Health, medium, swift, melee fighter, with strong defense. Yes, the wizard was basically the best character in the game. The elf was, though, my eventual all-time favorite. Fast, and fast meant loot, and loot meant you just raped everybody else who played you. Yeah. So, I guess I'll pick elf. Equipment. Change equipment. You can change your equipment, really? Okay, whatever. Starting game in 4 seconds.
Hey, you're nice.
Oh. I need to fix the audio on my thing. No?
Let's get out of here.
Is it my volume?
Awesome. Woohoo! Yeah.
It's probably my stupid audio.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Well, thanks. Hey, you're nice.
Really?
Thanks. Wow, thanks a bunch. Thanks.
I'm doing this because my fucking thing is on the fritz.
Hey, you're nice. Thanks. Wow, thanks a bunch.
There you go.
Hey, you're nice.
Can I? Oh, can't hear it. You have to use the analog sticks. That is fucking bullshit. Oh, no, you don't. If I hit my mode function, I'm good.
I'm in trouble.
All right, good. I just prefer gamepad. Sorry, I do. I don't like analog sticks.
I am Morak, the only wizard powerful enough to have summoned the gauntlet.
You summoned it?
This astral manifestation of my powers is a trial where only the...
Why would you summon the gauntlet? It's evil.
Find the three lost shards.
Oh, tutorial? Yeah, okay. I don't trust you.
No one has ever managed to acquire all the shards. I don't expect you to make it. But go on. Amuse me.
I don't really trust that guy.
Of course not.
Did you just make that quest up?
Yep.
The magical sword bit sounds nice, though. Maybe it could be traded in for a gold sword.
Well, this game must be self-aware. Because you can choose the level? Really? Oh, no. No, we're good. Host options. No, I'm good. Alright, whatever. The warrior is invulnerable to most attacks.
Let's see how you fare against the power of the dead.
So humans built this place to hang around and watch their dead? I don't get it. Oh, wait. They're undead. Oh, that makes more sense.
Where's my attack button? I know it's trivial and all, but... Oh, come on, achievement already? Yeah. I don't like getting achievements for playing the fucking game. I want achievements that mean something. That's the thing developers don't understand. Way back in the day, achievements did actually mean a few things in life. You didn't just get one for turning the game on and saying hi. Left trigger? The fuck does that do? Right trigger... Okay.
Undead humans. If you don't think living ones are smelly enough, stay dead this time, you hear?
You can't fire like you could in the original. Like, rapid fire. Like, okay, right trigger does that. Left trigger does that. I don't know what the fuck that does. I just don't. Oh my god. Right analog stick fires. It's like Smash TV. It's a twin stick Smash TV game. That's not what I was expecting, but alright. Because I didn't expect it. Don't shoot the food. Because I didn't know it was food, asshole. And I'm only doing like left trigger attacks. The right trigger attacks. It's Smash TV. It's Smash TV. I get it. I never was good at Smash TV. I'll just get the key. Can I please break bosses now? Yeah. There we go. Hope my mic's coming through okay. Well, there you go. Okay. It is Smash TV, Smash TV. I bet you one hit and you die, like always. Actually, that wasn't always the case. Smash TV was one hit deaths, almost. There were times where you get away with getting hit twice. Like, barely, like the club would hit you and you could get away. I've done it, I was actually participating in it once. But it is so rare, it might as well not happen. Basically, if you get hit, you die. This one, I hope you just have a health. Why would you shoot the food? Because we didn't know the food was there. I wonder if there was exploding barrels like in Diablo. And I'm talking about the original, mind you. See, don't destroy food. Well, I didn't fucking know it was... You know, I'm gonna just destroy every fucking food by accident on the goddamn planet. There, I grab some food. Food. Yeah. Is this gonna be a collectathon where you just have to get everything? Ghostbusters the game was good, but it really was a collectathon too. Because you had to get all the artifacts, all the cursed artifacts. Fine. There. No. An amazing feat for a mortal. Really? Well, that's fine. If this gets me into the spirit of Gauntlet eventually, then I will forgive the flaws that I don't like about the game. Because recapturing the spirit of Gauntlet for Nintendo for the NES or Gauntlet Dark Legacy for the PlayStation, you know. If you can recapture that for me, because Gauntlet Dark Legacy was actually kind of a repeat, a port of the arcade game. And then a port was like Gauntlet Dark Prophecy or whatever, which was the same thing. You can destroy that door. Lovely. So I don't have to unlock that other door. I can save my keys. Aha. Oh.
The food was shot to pieces by the swift little elf.
Well, shut up. Yeah. Okay, I don't get a chance to go to that area. If you don't go to it, you lose it. Explosives! I have defeated the purpose of the explosives by detonating them off camera. Yes. And apparently you can drop bombs. I have no idea if you have infinite of those. It seems I have infinite of these two. But we don't know for sure. These tracking arrows. I never was good at twin stick shooters. Never. Okay. Carry explosives. I can carry the explosives? I don't know if I want to. Elf. Green elf. Needs food badly. Green elf, you're about to die. Buy more health right now. That's what you would hear in the arcades all the time. Buy more health. Yeah. Well, apparently I can pick this up. So. Really? I don't have a key? Well.
This was actually really good.
Well, good. Don't shoot food. Well, apparently it doesn't matter. These explosives respawn, and there must be a reason for it, which I have no idea about, because they've removed the time limit, but... that was left R1. And that's that. I have run out. Left R1 is the magic. Great. Well, apparently you can pick it up, so there must be a reason for it. I figured it would be blow up these carcasses, these sarcophagus that are in the way, but apparently not. So, can you blow up the door? It's painful to watch this because I have no idea how to fucking progress. And I am stuck. Yeah. Yeah, this is fucking fun, game! Just make a guy stuck within the first fucking 5 minutes of playing. Yeah, that's fun. That's fun. That's just... no keys, no nothing. Just... oh, there's a crack in the door here. Where are your Zelda skills when you need them? Well, you know what? I wasn't expecting puzzles like this in a gauntlet game. Maybe walls you shoot to unlock new areas. Well, that's it. That's all I get. That's it. That's... figured it would do a thing now, but no, it just opened up an area for food. Food's fine, but what the fuck? I'm glad I'm not on a timer, because I'd be dead by now. Where'd I get the key from? I don't know. We don't know. Yellow Archer needs food badly.
Don't mean to alarm you, but looks like we got company.
Okay. Yeah. I'm not big on the Smash TV aspect of it, but then again, I guess Gauntlet was the precursor to Smash TV, right? So, can you really be mad? No. No, you can't. You just suck at Smash TV, and this is bringing back old arcade memories. So, yeah. To be honest, is this what Smash TV needed? Maybe. Can't say it's a good or a bad thing. You need to stop throwing curses at me. I just want to hum the original Gauntlet music. They should have had that option. Yeah. Yellow Archer needs food badly. I must be max health. There was no max health in Gauntlet. You just kept getting more and then it expired. So, yay. Left trigger. Yeah. I'll just throw a bomb out there. Good thing you have infinite bombs. I'm not sure what the purpose of this hard shot is. This right here. Just because, you know, I don't know. I have a key, but do I want to unlock that door? Well, there's loot over there, that's for sure. But there's a lot of dudes over there, too. So many dudes. All of the dudes. There. Yeah, there you go. How many dudes? All of the dudes. Alright. Well, we got some food. And I don't think we can max out on that. So let's just keep going. Looks like I could shoot down that ledge for more gold, but who knows. Don't shoot food. But it's so much fun to shoot food. What's this skull coins crap? Oh, it's secrets, it's collectibles. Great, just what Gauntlet didn't need. Smash TV. You can't shoot when you're hard aiming, so yeah. I wonder if there's a cap in the game to how many enemies they'll allow on screen. I'm not sure. Those things blow up, so I don't know. Can you just farm points all day? I'm not sure. I wonder if you can get splash damage from your own attacks. I was! Fuck's wrong with you? Jump? Oh. That doesn't really do a whole lot. Yeah, I guess now that I've killed everybody, it's not supposed to. And crates with no treasure icon yield no loot. But you'll never know that. You'll always think there'll be a key inside one of them. So you'll always destroy them. Even if you're wrong. Yep, you could be wrong. In fact, you probably are wrong. But you will never admit defeat, because it's a game, and you cannot let the game beat you. That's what you do. And this guy's going to blow up, and do all sorts of fun things to me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Get back. Oh, fucking sit down, would you? There you go. You're just not. I think I played the sit down card too early. I should have saved that for a boss. But it's alright. I'll just play it again. It'll be overplay at that point. Yeah, I don't care. Don't really care. Is the spirit of the game hitting you yet, Zen? Maybe. Still feels a little Smash TV-ish. But it does not feel quite as, Torchlight. So that's pretty good. Torchlight had a lot of, bullshit moments. Especially the amber shit. Like, morphine. Okay, there you go. Let's just get all the loot. How does he carry all this loot? Zen, if you're asking for realism in a game, I know, you can't double jump in real life, so get over yourself. Exactly. Kills. Crown bonus. I got one crown. Okay, cool. Mastery's unlocked. As luck would have it, destroy 10 props. Bronze, 2000. I don't want currency. Mortal Kombat Deadly Alliance did it, and it was such a grind fest to open up the entire tomb. It was almost worth cheating. You know? It just was. Oh, I probably could have changed weapons or something like that.
Someone approaches.
What? Someone approaches. Well, apparently death takes no damage, so. Alright. Maybe I should have picked the Valkyrie. I feel like I would have enjoyed her better. Oh, death is still on my ass. Okay. This is a lesson in greed, apparently. You know? Do you stay around and collect the gold, or do you, you know? That phantom in Spelunky was only added because the creator of the game was sad that people were getting all the money. He's like, no, this game isn't supposed to be played that way. Then people just realized that the ghost's touch turned all of the gems into the maximum value gem diamonds, and then people would just exploit it, and then it just defeated the purpose of him altogether. I mean, he never should have been added, because it's just the developer being butthurt, you know? Like, who gives a fuck if people play the game in the way you didn't expect? I mean, seriously. You know? If people found a way to exploit your game engine, that's fucking good for them. You know, stop being goddamn butthurt over the goddamn situation. This is not cool because, I couldn't get through. I can avoid death in a circular fashion.
This one could be worth a lot.
Eat your food. Don't destroy it. Well, I didn't mean to destroy it. Just saying. I wonder if destroying death is eventually going to be a thing. You know, I never actually beat the first gauntlet, to be honest. I got pretty damn far in it, and I found most all of the secrets to warp ahead a lot, but by warping ahead, you miss the treasure rooms, and by missing the treasure rooms, you missed a lot of life recharging, so by doing that, it was technically hard mode at that point. Eat the food. Don't destroy it. Is there an achievement for destroying, like, 500 foods in the game? I don't know. There might be. Death has an interesting aura of effect. Oh, I think this is reminiscent of the, black death things, the Black Reapers that you could summon in the original, not summon, but, like, you'd open up a chest and there they'd be. But in that game, you could actually kill them if they took enough damage. Here, death cannot take enough damage. So, I was thinking being in his aura alone would be enough to, get rid of some. Now death is sort of a permanent fixture. He's not something that you free. In some cases, you didn't have a choice. You had to free death because he was, like, part of an environment. But then you would just kill him. You shouldn't avoid him because he was fast and... Well, I took some damage there. Unnecessary damage. Yeah. Alright. Ow. Looks like I'm nearly dead. About to faint, huh? Green Archer needs food badly. You think? Well. But there's no food. It says 3790. Starve. I'm not gonna starve. I thought that 3790 was my health, but apparently it's my gold. Elf needs food badly. For some reason, I prefer that deeper voice over this new one. Then again, it's for a new game, so adding too much of the old, you know. There's some food. Uh-oh. Well, there's some coinage. 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 Well, I want to kill everybody, damn it. Because that's what you do in these games. You beat the fuck out of everything and get all of the loots. Because greed is how you play the game. There is no rest for the greedy in this game. Everybody knows that. Everybody. So you have to play it as a greedy bitch. That's just what you do. The barbarian threw axes in the original. In the Valkyrie, she threw swords. And the wizard fireballs. Once I learned the game, yes, the elf was my favorite. But It didn't mean he was the best character. By far, I think the best character... I want to say the wizard. I mean, I honestly do. But to be fair, I think it was the chick. I used to call her the Amazon. It's just because she had the highest defense and still a good attack. Always pushes me up to 500. 30, 13, 4, 60. What's the point of gold in this game? If you can't spend it. You know? This looks like a detour to the left there. That's a detour. Yeah, like optional over here. Maxi's Momarian. Okay, so change equipment. I haven't unlocked it yet. Okay, you have to use your gold for that stuff. Alright. I get it. Each character has its own gold reserve. So we'll go back and play with other characters.
You're still alive.
Yes.
Welcome then to the scene of your death. Let the games begin.
Did I just shoot food again?
You know what? If I didn't know better, I'd say this looks like a trap.
There you go. This looks like something I can collect. Yep. Because treasure is a thing, and everybody likes it. Yeah. Everybody wants greed. Everybody is greed, actually. It's balancing that greed with the rest of your life. I don't think it's useful to... Oh, grenade. I don't think it's useful to grab food if you're max health. Unlike Gauntlet, where you could just store infinite health because it kept ticking down. Mechanic of the game, your time limit was your health, because they said the very air of Gauntlet was poisoned, so it was draining you, sapping your energy. Yeah, that was just a shitty, that was an excuse for a shitty game mechanic, to be honest.
That spawner really needs to be taken out.
Spawner, I like how he calls it spawner. I mean, that's what we call it as gamers, you know? Summoner, summoning stone might be area, but I guess spawner works. Look, you can take a shortcut back across. Let's play the no shortcut game, shall we? Yeah. He has infinite arrows, because realism, what's that? Spawners have a lot more health than they used to. Alright. Hey, I thought I killed all the spawners. I hit A. There you go. So that's the use of them after all. Alright. Haha, I figured it out. La 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 la.
More monsters again.
That's only one music of Gauntlet. Like, I knew another song too, you know. That one, yeah. Come on, when is this gonna be over? I'm getting bored now. I want to move on to the next area. Gauntlet was not about spending an ungodly amount of time in one board. It wasn't. It was about doing your thing and moving on. Alright.
I hit A, dumbass. I hit A. I hit A. Bullshit.
You didn't think I'd be gone for good, did you? I wish I had some of that elf bread.
Is that a Lord of the Rings reference?
Alright, so apparently I spent a shit ton of money on reviving. Like, 10,000 on reviving. So I'm never gonna get new weapons, because if reviving is that expensive, yeah.
Your life force is running out.
Shut your balls. It doesn't tick down like it used to. Alright, and you just robbed me of 15,000, so go fuck yourself. With A not working when I try to jump across the thing. So go eat it. So go eat a dick. I blame the game for that, not me. Well, anyway. I guess I still have that stuff. Right. Well, I completed the mummy stuff. Alright, let's do this. Change equipment. Let's, info lore.
Wrought from a cursed willow, the bow rides with ancient magic.
I have a feeling I should just save up for this one. Otherwise, you'll never get to it, right? Left button. Oh my god, you can also unlock stuff. All kinds of stuff. 80,000! This is appearance. It doesn't even do anything, it's just appearance. Like, it doesn't give you any armor or anything. This is just cosmetics. This does effects for your character. You know, host options. I don't know. Come on, all that money. Now I can see where the microtransactions would come in.
Hey, yeah, buy more gold so you can.
Very partial to swords and shields.
Partial to swords and shields. Right. Do you collect it, though? Yes, but can it read? No, not really. Right. So, all that good stuff is mine. Look, practice dummies. Yay. As luck would have it. I already unlocked that one, didn't I? Anyway. Yeah, I can carry explosives, I know. Is there a point? Probably. Enemy discovered. Skeleton defender. Well. Okay, it didn't cost me 10,000 to revive, I get it. But, I guess there was a cost. You don't use the buttons too often, that dash, or, yeah, that. You don't use it too often. Although, I wonder if you can go through enemies with it. I bet you thought I was gonna skip that. And you almost were right. In real life, you can't jump 20 feet like that from a dead standstill, but in real life, you can't double jump, so. Yeah. Basically, it says don't discuss reality when talking about my game. That's what it means when it says, in reality, you can't double jump. Because reality is a moot point. There's a crown.
This one could be worth a lot.
Maybe. Yeah, do I have enough footage for a first impression? Yeah, probably. But I still want to keep playing just to see what happens. Don't know what that did, but I'll take it. Right. Hmm. Trying to hit the spawner and I'm almost succeeding. Almost succeeding. Almost succeeding. And there we go. I have done it too.
That guy was fast, if you've noticed. That's that one music, but what's the other music I was humming out with Gauntlet? You know, it's funny, now I can't remember the other tune for Gauntlet. Now that I've been singing the Yeah, seriously, I cannot remember what I was just humming. Great. Now I have to think about it again. That's a funny thing in your brain. You forget things very easily. As easily as you recall them, as a matter of fact.
Another summoning thing.
Okay, there's a reason for that. This summoner is pretty quick, actually. It's summoning quite a bit of things. Gauntlet. Come on, I want to remember the first tune now, because the first tune is actually more memorable, but now I can't remember it. And then you might argue, well, Zen, it must mean the second tune is more memorable if you can't remember the first one. Hey, shut up. I'm doing my best here. Alright. Ah. There you go. There's some health for you. I have a feeling I missed some shit back there. I probably did. Nope.
Looks like we got company.
Oh, that one grenade was enough to take out the thingy. Got it. Hooray! Gauntlet music. It's classic. Almost too classic. Is that a thing? Probably.
A necromancer. How did he get in here?
I wonder. Necromancer? How did he get in here? Hit and run tactics, my friend. Hit and run tactics on the spawners.
One less problem in the world.
You said that. Okay, he's running out of things to say.
He's turning. You're in for a treat now.
Really?
Look at that! How did the huge blue guy fit inside the little one?
You're self-aware. He's gonna summon more of these ads, most likely. Yeah, let's put a bomb on him. Oh, he ran away. What a tool. Alright. Enemy discovered. Ghost.
This one could be worth a lot.
Yeah, he drops treasure, too. Alright. I got him.
It's just like my mom said. Evil sorcery won't get you anywhere.
Maybe, but it'll certainly make you rich. I don't want to carry explosives. It's not a fun mechanic for me. I don't like looking for cracks in the walls. You know? Well, there's one. Fine, wait for them to respawn. And they won't. You had one chance and you cocked it up. Yay. Well, how was I to know? The other areas had respawning. Yeah, inconsistent game mechanics. Inconsistent game mechanics. I'm gonna blame the game on that one. What is this, a Stanley Parable now? Jeez. Yeah, it's the smart ass. Ah, there's explosives. If I don't destroy them, then maybe, just maybe. Looks like I destroyed them anyway. Well, there's an explosive in that top corner that I could probably handle. I'm quite happy with the bombs.
Let's just destroy that summoning thing.
Yep, time to go back. I've got an explosive now. Let's do it. They gave me one more chance. Gauntlet style. This is not gauntlet style at all. This, my friend, is totally different. Alright. Magic. Food. Gold. Still trying to remember the other tuna gauntlet. I knew it would come back to me. Then it won't stay in my head. I'll forget it again. Because the other tune is just makes everything else forgettable. Alright. That really makes you walk slow. There you go. When you do the other trigger button. I got hit again. Yeah. Yeah, well. You almost remind me of the dude in Seventh Guest. You know. Feeling lonely. Yes. Well. Alright. Considering I've never played the game before and I'm almost dead, that's expected. I need food.
Elf needs food badly.
Thanks. I didn't know that until you said it just now. If you can be smartass to me, I can be a smartass to you. Find me my three sections of the door so that you can get treasure, but no one has survived. Probably because it was sent into pieces for a reason, and that reason's probably to imprison you.
Because if I actually do this thing, you'll just revive and be more powerful than I could possibly imagine. Yeah, like, I'm not stupid. I know how these things work. Then again, people were saying, no, Zen, that's not it. This guy has all the good intentions. And I don't... Yeah, I'll believe that one when me shit turns purple and smells like rainbow sherbet, you know. I just die. Shitballs. And yeah, it's not cool. Can I just revive infinitely? Because I'm by myself and it usually requires a person to help you. Just asking. There go all the crowns that I lost. I just got back. I guess a crown can help you live a little longer, but, I don't have any keys, so, yeah. Can't open those things. There's a key. Now you can choose. You must choose, but choose wisely. Alright. The true grail will give you life. The false grail will take it from you. There you go. No more keys. You done fucked up, Zen. There ain't no more keys around here. Oh, yeah, there's one more key around here. Heroic hunger. Shoot a bunch of food, probably. Yeah. I knew there was an achievement for that. I didn't even try. It just happened. Because this key is obviously meant to open up that door, I'm going to see if I can break the game by opening up the bottom door instead. Probably not, though. There's probably another key down here for the same purpose. There you go. You don't seem to get any EXP for killing these things, so it's just a thing that you can do. And there's a key. And there's food. And there's all of the things that you can collect. Okay, it doesn't break the game. Nicely enough. It's just more area to unlock. Yeah, I got your strategy down now. You can't be scared of all the spikes. You have to walk through it. And I was going to make a rhyme, but I couldn't. Right. Right. Here's what I think about that. That's the magic. Let's use my infinite grenades that just take a while to respawn. Those that do damage to the spawners. Alright, there we go. That's two grenades. You can't seem to do damage to them until they're fully fully spawned in, which is a bit annoying. I think my audio just crapped again. Alright, let's see, what is this? Carry. Well, alright. I guess we have to put the thing on the thing. Yeah. I can't hear it. My things are screwed up again. Alright. Ah, there we go. Not cool. Oh, there you go. treasure is the driving force of this game.
Right. This one could be worth a lot.
Ow. Yeah.
Where am I? Alright, gauntlet. Got it.
Don't know how many revives I have. Maybe infinite. Because it's single player. Which means this game is much more valuable with more than one player. Nope. Dropper of crowns, huh? Alright, well, whatever. I ain't gonna drop that again. For the first time, for the last time. Alright. Floor cleared. Told you I'm saving up for 40,000 for the best weapon. I'm not gonna spend it on crap. There you go. I'm halfway there. As luck would have it, Heroic Hunger, Dropper of Crowns, you get bonus money for that. Hey, I'm almost there. Cool. You get money for achievements. Achievements mean better weapons. Because of money. That's an okay way to do achievements. I'm happy for that. So, yay. You don't want me to get out of it alive. That's the thing. Ow. There we go. Drop. Drop.
If you keep destroying food like that, you'll have none to eat.
Yeah, I know. I like to destroy the food. It's what I do. Ah, there we go. Whatever. I like how he puts the food behind boxes so that you're tempted to shoot it. Like this. See? Didn't even mean to. I just hit one arrow and it went through all of it. Which is annoying. Mind you. Oh, there goes my crown.
This one could be worth a lot.
I think the crown's like a get out of jail free card. You get hit with it down to the lowest, and then you drop it, and then it'll keep you alive a little bit longer. Well, those are the ghosts. They're making a reappearance. They make you drop your crown. Which is annoying. Because you don't want to leave that behind. I don't think the explosives actually hurt this thing.
Shiny.
Green elf needs food badly. Okay, you died. But the other summon ghost is still around. Ah, Stahl, you made me lose my crown permanently, you asshole. It's now back there where I can't get it. I thought it couldn't do that. Look, it's over there. I can't get it. Or it was over there. Ugh. I lost it permanently. No crown bonus. Yeah, see? Fuck. Alright, well, whatever. I want to do that one again. Can I? Holy shit, you can. You can redo levels.
Elf.
I didn't actually want to do it, but I couldn't find a way to back out of it, so now I'm doing this level again. Okay, so you guys are going to get round two of this. Lovely. I didn't know I was destroying the food. Eating off the floor. I have no idea what that is. I mean, I just ate a bunch of food. Yeah, shut your balls. Well, I didn't want to play this thing again. I just didn't know if you could, and then when I tried, I couldn't back out of it. So, lovely. Give me that crown. Ow. You whore. Break out of that. Alright. Those ghosts are annoying. Ow. Well, yeah, if I wouldn't continuously drop it. Right. Well, I guess you can farm a level then. Because of all of this, you know. I see what you did there, game. Putting all the gold on the spikes. Yeah, I see what you did there. Well, at least I know you can farm. This is actually a decent level to farm, to be honest. Hey, no gold left behind if we can help it. Yeah. I got the crown this time. Yeah. Give me that crown. 40,000. Cool. Eating off the floor. Destroy the food 10 times. But I've already done that. Alright, well, the game continues on for some time, it looks like. And there's the end. Wow. Lovely. Tell you what, I'll play just up until this mark here. And then I'll call it a game. I've already been playing long enough for a first impression. Okay, maybe just these three. This one is a sidetrack. And then I'll call it a deal. Okay, change equipment. I'm going to... Elf ability, right button. Oh, it's 100,000 for the potion ability. Appearance, weapons, this one I want. There you go. I just skipped all of that shit. And there you go. Now I get to try that out really quick. I didn't even buy the other ones. Fuck it, I just scroll right to the end. Oh. Is that what those side areas are? The paths of the shards? Whoa. Gauntlet Slayer Edition achievement unlocked. As luck would have it, gold destroyed 800 props with one hero. I thought I already had that achievement. Like, you can't destroy gold. You can only free it. You can only liberate it. So you can't shoot and destroy it. So, see? Shots go right over it. Well, that's alright. I just get to use my strong bombs. Well, I don't have a fancy bow. I just have the fancy bomb. Apparently, I just spent all my treasure on one bomb upgrade. I was hoping it would be a weapon, but... Oh, it is a weapon, but... Alright, well... I see that I'm supposed to pick this up. Yeah. Just wasn't sure what it wanted me to do in Terum. You know? I guess we're taking the long way around. Oh, I see. It's one of those. Alright, we're cool. I can't remember what the subtitle of this game was. Gauntlet something. It's obviously the remake, but now I'm not remembering it. You know? I wonder if you can pause mid-game. Like, because it's multiplayer and all, I'm not sure. Uh-huh. Cool. Let's kill all the pots. Link's got nothing on me, man. I'm the only elf pot destroyer in the game world. Yeah, just don't read too much into that. I certainly didn't. We won't ask. Alright, well. Yeah, see, nothing's ever in these. Is this a... yeah. Just an area for more treasure. Now I get the whole torchlight vibe with this. It's not a good or a bad thing, but I did get bored with torchlight. Especially in the grindy sections. hello? I couldn't move. Oh, there's a reason I couldn't move, because that's a part of the map you can't walk on.
Welcome back, Elf.
No, really, I didn't think you couldn't walk on that area. I didn't see the environment. Achievement unlocked. Icy Tomb. Oh, okay, you can only die so many times. Well, that's good. Let's just quit the map. All right, I've played enough for a first impression, and... what's it called anyway? Gauntlet Slayer Edition. That's Gauntlet Slayer Edition for you guys. Available on GOG and probably other platforms as well. I got it on sale for a really good deal, I think a couple dollars at the time. This would be a game that I'll keep playing just because it's hack and slash classic Smash TV meets Torchlight 2 to give you Gauntlet. So... you know, yes, I want to go to the lobby. All right, well, I guess this is good. Maybe I'll get to the end and then record just the end for next week. Who knows? Until then, see you guys and keep gaming.